Please rise for the national anthem, which will be performed by the BHS Choir under the direction of Ms. Sarah Heron.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and all its red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Welcome, everyone, to the Class of 2020 graduation ceremony. This is certainly not the ceremony I envisioned when we first talked about this day back in September. I pictured us being together, like actually being together, in the spring, into senior week, and on this graduation day. That's not what we got, is it? As I thought about it, though, I realized you shouldn't let this pandemic change the arc of your life. The journey you are on might get altered because of what we're experiencing, but that really shouldn't change who's on the journey. So in the midst of these disruptions to your life, be who you are until you figure out who you are. I know that sounds kind of strange, be who you are until you figure out who you are, but that really is the arc of your life. I actually like being me, but it took a while to figure out who I was. In high school, which was in the 80s, I lived through popped collars, barracuda jackets, Adidas Stan Smiths, and Izod. But I didn't really know what the heck any of those were. I think my mom shopped for most of my clothes. Part of being me meant I was sometimes embarrassed about who I was because I leaned away from what was trendy. At one point, I wore a beret and I had my ear pierced. I was usually pretty happy in my own skin, but it's certainly been an ongoing journey to become me. I also escape from myself sometimes, and that's part of figuring out who I am too. I have some simple escapes like reading or playing COD or even dressing up during Spirit Week. I get to test out other ways of being when I do those things. The big escape you all know about is LARPing. I started the LARP club here at school, and while it's a great club to have at a high school, there's a selfish part of me that it gets to escape from being me. I think one of my favorite characters I played was Cook. He was a pretty simple guy with simple goals in life, but sometimes he wouldn't act the same way Bob Jezokas would. It's good to test out other ways of being, and LARP let me do that. In the end, Cook ended up getting eaten himself by a band of orcs. Now, that's not a good way of being, but c'est la vie. To this day, I still change. I'm still on my arc of life, and I'm still figuring out who I am. I look back at those photos from high school with my black beret, or I look at my college yearbook and I have hair down to the middle of my back. I think, yikes, who is that guy? Under those images, though, I know I was working and thinking and asking questions and trying to figure out who to be. In the last 10 years as an assistant principal, I talked to a lot of students after things didn't go so well for them. I used to ask freshmen and sophomores to try to imagine who they would be as seniors. And then I'd ask them to step into the shoes of their imagined older self to become who they were going to be. Today, I'm certainly not the person I was in high school. In fact, Mr. Fournier probably wouldn't want that 17-year-old working at his high school. And Mike, I promise, I've moved past all of those shenanigans. Well, most of them anyway. As you, the class of 2020, step off the stage today, step onto the arc of your life. You'll find that arc is going to bridge right over this pandemic. Go be who you are and go figure out who you'll become. I wish you the very best. Now it gives me great pleasure to ask the members of the BHS Choir to perform their final selection for the year titled The Climb.
I'm taking
Please welcome the BHS Mission Statement Award winner, Caitlin Bowles.
During the first week of quarantine, I was sitting at my dining room table, and I said to my sister, "Whoever says our graduation speech better not make it about coronavirus." I was scared, and I knew that the class of 2020 is about so much more than a pandemic that blindsided us during our final months here. In the words of One Direction, you and me got a whole lot of history. So I want to tell you a story instead, one you probably know already but haven't heard. Once upon a time, it was 2008. There was a first grade class in a computer lab about to take the NEWA test. They typed in their unmemorized 7-digit 99 numbers, followed by their year of graduation. The year 2020 sounded like it would be memorable for all of the right reasons. A few years down the line, it was their last day of fourth grade. On that day, the entire Bedford High School class of 2020 met in a gym at McKelvey Intermediate School. Since that day, 8 years ago, the class has lost and gained many special people, but everyone has a special place in this class. On that day, when the fourth graders of Riddlebrook, Peter Woodbury, and Memorial all collided in one chaotic gym, a never-ending yet subtle competition began. Which elementary school had the best playground? Which school had the best teachers and events? And most importantly, which school bred the best kids? These were debates I heard at lunch tables 7 years later in the Bedford High cafeteria. I guess you can't deny your roots. In McKelvey, this class was highly important for one very iconic reason, the banning of pasta from the playground. One morning in fifth grade, the class of 2020 banded together in a fight to spread raw spaghetti into the fists of everyone at morning recess and splash the noodles into puddles. Of all the unexpected news this class received, my personal favorite would have to be Mr. Fournier's voice on the intercom banning raw pasta from the playground. There is only one class to thank for that rule. In Lurgio, somewhere within the huge mix of the splitting of math classes, a mysterious gorilla sighting at Cardigan, readathons, and competitions of which pods would be released first for bus dismissal, one thing really caught the eyes of the class of 2020. Tummy yummies. I don't have much to say about that one, but it was weird. Fast forward to August 25th, 2016, when this group of kids enter a building for a long journey that won't actually feel very long at all. They are told right away that 4 years goes by very fast, but they don't know that they won't even get four. They are uncomfortable in their own skin and are constantly looking at their backwards reflection to be sure that they won't be made fun of for having a bulky freshman backpack. Their young faces are scared at the full-grown look of some of the upperclassmen. They're growing up at rapid speed. It won't be long until they become the role models. Their silly, best Lurgio couples Instagram pages turn into more mature, captivating pages like BHS Dog Section, Films to Inspire, Runaway Bulldog, and too many to count senior project pages serving as instruments to convey to the world the passions and the hearts of these 371 kids. But the class of 2020's first few months at Bedford High School are just about as chaotic as their final months will be. But in hindsight, it's all really funny. We greet the school with a lice epidemic. Happy fall. At our first pep rally, we receive the famous Go Home Freshman chant. Expected. Unexpected was 1 year later. We received a chant no one had ever heard before. Go home, sophomores. Hate us because they ain't us. We were truly a force to be reckoned with at those pep rallies and were even kindly given a go home juniors chant the following year. When we were finally at our prime point, senior year, the place you wait on the sidelines for 3 years to finally get to, we heard a news report on April 16th that sounded a whole lot like go home seniors. This is the story of Bedford High School's class of 2020, but it isn't finished yet. I know I said that I don't want to make coronavirus the defining characteristic of the class of 2020, but not addressing COVID-19 would be a lot like walking on the left side of the hallway. You just can't do that. Coronavirus is undoubtedly the only thing that has caused more of a dramatic stir than the video in fifth grade health class. Trying to speak to the hearts of 371 seniors who are all different from each other and find a way to unite us when we've been apart for so long is a hard thing to do. But weirdly enough, coronavirus might be the thing that united us the most. While no one in the world is exactly head over heels about this crisis, I think that being a senior in high school comes with a very big and unique price to pay, and everyone knew it. Celebrities trying to create virtual proms and graduations for us, parents and staff trying to make our senior year activities as close to what they would have been as possible, everyone turning around to look at us and show slivers of empathy whenever they could, all statements that they knew the magnitude of what we were missing. But what we were missing wasn't just those big things that you look forward to for 12 years in the back of your mind. There is something else there too, the ordinary moments. The moments that were not prom, and were not senior week, and were not senior night. The moments in between the big ones. The moments we never would have deemed as being special until we lost them forever. If I knew someone who was a senior during this and I wasn't one, I probably would say that it's so upsetting that you'll never have your senior prom. But I would never ever think to say that it's so upsetting you'll never have another quesadilla day with the people you grew up with. I wouldn't think of that because it's not something important to the mind like those big things. It's only important to the heart. Closing your locker for the last time, stepping out of your advisory room on the last day, taking your last sip of BHS water, your last school lunch, all moments that became significant when we found out we would never come back. I do not know one person who has learned gratitude the easy way. No one just wakes up thankful for everything just because. Many of us have recently learned that hidden inside of gratitude is a deep understanding that good moments aren't always guaranteed. To be truly grateful for something is to truly know deep in your heart that there might be a time in your life where that person, moment, feeling, or place won't be with you. We've watched three classes before us march through what we knew we would get eventually. Many of us have seen siblings go through it as well. And whether we acknowledged our excitement or not, I think that all of us deep down knew that these months would hold some of the most memorable moments of our BHS experience and would be the bridge of closure leading us to a new, complicated chapter in our lives. To be crossing that bridge alone is a tough thing to do. Isolation is not what we were made for, and it sure isn't helpful when you're standing at a huge crossroad in your life. We thought these months would be different, just like the rest of the world thought, but contrary to almost everyone else, we have thought these months would look different for years. And suddenly, the guaranteed, rite of passage moments aren't there anymore. And the hopeful echo of the world said, "Everything will be great when we return back to normal. But the senior class of 2020, there is just no normal to return back to." The graduating class of 2020 learned gratitude when it was too late to turn back around. And as painful as that sentence sounds, and whether you loved high school while you were living it or you didn't, I think we can all agree that that sentence is true to some degree. We came to know that while we complain incessantly about grades and homework, count down the days until vacation, Friday, or just 2:35 p.m., and would say openly how much we can't wait to get out of this place, we really did enjoy it, to the point where we wanted it back in a heartbeat. Gratitude. For weeks, I heard our conversations change in a very heartbreaking way. "If we just go back to school next week, everything will be okay," turned into, "If we just have a short sports season and prom, everything will be okay," turned into, "If we just have senior week and a normal graduation, everything will be okay." And through this change, we saw that everything was not okay. I learned that I would take any dreary Monday over nothing at all, because while some days meant unbrushed hair, sweatpants, naps and advisory, woke up too late for NHS, had to park in junior lot, and last minute homework in the hallway, those days also possessed a cafeteria full of laughter, a chaotic advisory A in the library, being with your friends, the sacred quesadilla day, and popcorn in Bulldog Corner. We took the good and the bad like it was nothing and forgot to cherish it because we didn't expect a once-in-a-lifetime history textbook event to come and take it. High school wasn't everybody's cup of tea, but saying goodbye to everything you've ever known is a hard thing to do no matter who you are. But I have more faith in this class than I ever have before. Courses teach you math. They teach you science and humanities. They teach you languages. Every graduating class that has walked out of the school has done their fair share of learning on these topics. This graduating class is different in a very big way. We did our fair share of learning in the classroom. But our 2020 vision, even though we never had a set class slogan, didn't see this coming. The class of 2020 graduates with real resilience. Because when senioritis kicked in really hard, and there were no more fun sports games or dances or advisory parties to look forward to, we still showed up. Sometimes late to remote learning, and in RPJs, obviously, and maybe skip some things. We were still all graduating because we did the work, even when the going got tough right at the end. That is real resilience. The class of 2020 graduates with humility, something you can't learn in a classroom. We were supposed to be really important this year. We were going to have clap outs and win another pep rally and get handed roses on senior nights, have banquets and barbecues and parties all for us. We give up those things that make us feel really important for nothing in return. And even though it wasn't our choice, we still all showed up to this stream today, and we will walk the stage soon, because we're going to graduate anyway, without the hype. That is real humility. And the class of 2020 graduates with real unity, because the struggle associated with losing the things many of us have looked forward to for so long brings us together in a very beautiful way. The class of 2020 has a special ring to it. People who go through pain together gain together. I've always been happy to be a part of this class, but I've never been prouder. There was a quote that I saw in the yearbook last year. It was somebody's senior quote from a TV show, Madam Secretary, and it went like this. You change the world right from where you're standing. There are plenty of people in the class of 2020 who will actually change the world. And I don't just say that because I'm giving a graduation speech. Because when you change the world right from where you're standing, you don't need a stage and you don't need thousands of people to know your name. I think that the way many people listening to this right now are going to change the world is rather by a ripple effect. Love causes a ripple effect. Change causes a ripple effect. Good people cause a ripple effect. And there is no shortage of these things in Bedford, New Hampshire. When you do those little things and change the people around you, the people around you change the people around them. And if we've learned anything from COVID-19, it's that things spread pretty quickly. The only way to truly change the world is by being exactly yourself, nothing less and nothing more. Sitting in living rooms all across Bedford right now, our captains and star athletes moving on to D1 schools. There are people who barely made varsity or never made varsity. There are people who joined non-cut sports with their friends for a good time. There are 4.0 students, there are 2.0 students, leads in the musical and ensemble kids, band and chorus soloists, IB diploma kids, and kids who would rather be laughing with their friends on a Tuesday night than writing down quotes for a Socratic seminar. And the best part about whichever of these you fit the most is that every person has a place. A good team has some star athletes and goofballs to make sure the passion never dies. Every class needs a crazy smart kid to raise their hand when no one else will, and also a chaotic, had 4 hours of sleep kid whose ideas and perspectives are worth hearing. No musical has all lead characters, and no club can be started with only 4 kids. The diversity of thought in this school is incredible, and altogether we made something unforgettable. The class of 2020 will not be forgotten. We are going to part ways and make new friends, have new adventures in different places, but you can only say that you grew up with a certain group of people, and we are that for each other. That is something irreplaceable. I feel like I have everything I need right here in this school with you guys, but time and life say otherwise. The clock doesn't stop ticking for a virus, or for a class whose stories were finished before their pens ran out of ink. But according to Hannah Montana, sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. It ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. I don't want to finish this speech because I know it might be my final words to some of you, but I need to. So, here's to our parents and families who had our backs through it all, who blessed us with car rides and lunch money so we actually could make these memories that we hold so close to our hearts. Here's to our teachers who taught us so much about the curriculum and about life. They never stopped teaching us and never stopped giving us chances, even when we made it really hard for them. Here's to our custodians, our nurses, lunch ladies and librarians, counselors and coaches, the unsung heroes who made our high school experience what it is. Thank you. Oh, wait. Wait, it's not done. Here's to Mr. Jazokas, Mrs. Noe, and Mr. Roop, who dealt with 10 times their fair share of panicked emails from us in the past few months. And here's to the graduates of the year 2020. If this is the last thing you hear from my voice, let it be this. Bulldogs. May the rest of your life contain the excitement level of seeing the PTG cookie cart coming down the hallway. And may you never forget to make every day a great day, Bulldogs.
Please welcome the Bedford High School Band and conductor, Ms. Kelsey Gaudette, for their performance of We're All in This Together.
Oh, all right, here we go.
Welcome the class president, Colin Stewart. Good evening. Thank you all for tuning in tonight to experience the graduation of the class of 2020. My name is Colin Stewart, and I am the president of the class of 2020 at Bedford High School. Though this may not be the graduation we all thought it would be, it certainly is something special and unique. There have definitely been some curveballs thrown that we did not see coming, but we stayed resilient and always found a way to hit it out of the park. This may have seemed like one of our longest journeys, but in reality, it is just a page or two in a multi-chapter novel. Life is kind of like a book in this way. Some chapters are sad, some are happy, and some are exciting. But if you never turn the page, you will never know what the next chapter has in store. Think about that as I talk to you today. Sometimes, we don't realize how fast life is moving when we are always looking at what's next. The next big event, the next holiday or school vacation. Too many times, we don't stop and take a look around and realize what actually surrounds each and every one of us. However, we certainly have come to a screeching halt now. Even though this is referred to as the best part of our high school experience, filled with lots of fun things and activities, there was no next thing for us to look forward to. Because when we were right around the corner from it, it was gone. Though the administration and student council have done a fantastic job trying to help us, we will never get back what we had before. So we are forced to let go of what was and accept what is. That can be and is hard, knowing we will never get our prom, a traditional graduation, and the time we should have had with our friends. But we must try to look forward and pick up what we think are the broken pieces created from this and accept that the world may not be falling apart right now as many of us think, and it is instead falling into place. Yes, we will never get back the time we lost, but we can choose to look at the positive side of things and keep moving forward. Being happy doesn't mean that everything is perfect. It means you have decided to look beyond the imperfections. It means that you have seen the good things all around us that are being covered by this darkness. Because that is what is important. I myself,
try to see the good things that come with this, and encourage others to do so as well. Because there are so many good things to be seen. We may be tired of spending so much time in our houses and not seeing a person from outside our household, but how often do we get this time with our families? How amazing is it to have a conversation with others and make new friends who we usually would pass right by? Or even just the ability to step back and take a breath from our busy day-to-day lives. No matter how much has been taken or given, there is one thing that can never be diminished. That is the memories that we made here at BHS in all the years before. The excitement one got when trading silly bands or Pokemon cards in elementary school. The first time we all came together as one, the first day of fifth grade. Or during Derby Day in Cardigan, where we made friends and memories that are still remembered and talked about today. Even the memory of walking through the front doors the first day of high school as a freshman and going through all the firsts of high school, not realizing how little time we would have there. Or storming the court as sophomores during the pep rally. Though a little unsafe, it showed our excitement and unity as a grade. Some of us have been here since kindergarten, and lots more have joined throughout the way. And we also remember those who aren't with us today. It feels amazing to look back and see how much we have accomplished. The friends we made, the homework assignments we did the class before they were due, and the hundreds of tests we may or may not have studied for to get to this moment. But now, we also have to look at what's next in our lives, because there is a lot of opportunity and achievement for everyone graduating in this class. A common thing that people like to say is that individuality and uniqueness are the keys to success. However, I think that though these are important qualities, they are not in fact the total picture. Connecting with others and working with different people are much more important, and is your uniqueness and individuality you bring to the group that are most important. Since everyone comes from different places and backgrounds, we all have different strengths, weaknesses, and ideas that can help others. What you bring to the table is so important, and you should always remember that. At the same time, you should also remember who was there for you and how they helped you. They are what is most valuable. I want to tell you a quick story that symbolizes this. A grandfather brought his grandson to fly a kite at the park. The boy watched as the kite flew through the air. He watched as it flew back and forth and in all different directions. But it could not go any higher than the string would allow. So he asked his grandfather if they could cut the string as to allow the kite to fly higher and soar even farther than before. The grandfather helped his grandson cut the string, and they let the kite go. At first, the kite did indeed soar higher than before, but it was not even a couple minutes before the kite fell down to the ground. The grandson was confused and asked his grandfather why the kite had not flown higher, as they had cut the string, so there was nothing to hold it back. His grandfather explained, "In the life we live in, we sometimes think that our friends and family are holding us back and keeping us from reaching new heights, and we fail to realize that these are the people that help us survive with their love and support. The string is what kept the kite flying in the right direction, and without it, there was no support, and the kite fell down." This story teaches us two things. One is that collaboration and working with others can help us succeed. The string and the kite work as one in a relationship that if either did not function properly, the kite would not fly. The second is that you should not be afraid to reach for new heights. This class especially is going all over the country and world. There are lots of new things out there that we have not yet experienced, and nothing can prepare us for it. And you should not feel prepared, since you really can't be. What you can do is remember what you learned here at BHS. Remember, your friends and family are always there for you, and they are the people you can trust to reach out to and lean on, because no matter where you are not alone. Have confidence in yourself and your abilities, because if you never do anything new, then you will never be more than you are. And this class especially has so much more room to grow. But don't wait too long. Time goes much quicker than we expect, as we learned during our time here, and no one can really stop a ticking clock. But the great ones know how to slow it down. This is a quote by Kevin Costner in the movie Draft Day, produced on April 7, 2014, which I accessed on April 10, 2017. Another important lesson I learned here at BHS is that I always need to cite my work. I think that this is a very important quote that everyone should remember. savor those important moments, and try to have as much fun as you can. They say nothing lasts forever, but I know that friendship can last a lifetime. Finally, I encourage everyone not to worry about what things could become. In the words of the great Walt Disney, if you have done the very best you can, then worrying won't make it any better. As long as you work hard and do the very best you can, things have a way of working out. You can't change the past, and you definitely cannot control the future. What you can do is look at yourself in the present and realize how much you have to offer to the world. Remember who you are. BHS is having friends that we will keep for the rest of our lives, and I guess that means we really are all in this together. Because once a bulldog, always a bulldog. Don't be afraid to turn that page and explore what the next chapter has in store for you. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it. Thank you.
At this time, I'd like to take a moment to recognize the seniors entering military service. They are Spencer Almeida, Army National Guard, Kobe Brown, United States Marines, Caitlin Dindorf, United States Air Force Academy, Sierra Dindorf, United States Air Force Academy, Alexander DeWitty, United States Air Force, Peter Falvey, United States Army, Elizabeth Flynn, United States Air Force Academy, Ethan Freitzel, United States Coast Guard, Max Gagnon, United States Marines, Sierra Iron Moccasin, United States Army, Anna Kim, United States Naval Academy, Cole LeMay, United States Air Force, Max Lebelzek, United States Air Force ROTC, Colby Martell, United States Air Force, Ethan McAllister, Army National Guard, Nathan Statiris, United States Navy Reserves, Alexander Winslow, United States Coast Guard. At this time, Mr. Michael Fournier, Superintendent of Schools, will address the class of 2020.
Good morning, faculty, families, school board, and members of the class of 2020. I have two thoughts I'd like to share with you today. The first is one that is important to me and my family. It is this: the journey is more important than the destination. The work you did, the choices you made, and the lives you touched between your first day of school and today have woven together who you are far greater than just one ceremony. So celebrate the journey, not just the destination. And remember this sentiment when you enter your next chapter. Memories, character, and life is built on the journey. The destination is simply the candles on the cake to be celebrated. The second thought I would like to share is that of perspective. We've heard these last few months of what you have lost in your senior year. Perhaps the inverse is actually true. What have you gained? Did you lose each day to be together with your friends? Or did you gain family dinners, quiet reflection, and the slowing of a supercharged busy schedule? Did you lose your senior prom? Or did you gain deeper conversations, connections with people that would have been otherwise missed, or the actual benefit of knowing what it's like to be bored? You see, for the last decade or more, the adults in your lives have known that our kids are overscheduled, stressed out, and filled with anxiety about all they have to do and who they ought to be. Since March, we have been forced to slow down, to take a breath, and to center our thinking and work through the reality of this journey. So, before our world gets too far back to what it once looked like, think about the journey you've taken since March, what you've learned on that journey, and the good ways in which you've been impacted, how you've impacted others, and how you've grown. I'm proud of you and look forward to watching you make an impact on our world, make it a better place with all the lessons that you've learned. Congratulations, I'm proud of you.